वेलकम टू लर्निंग विद डॉक्टर शिवांगी. टुडेज टॉपिक इज फंक्शंस ऑफ पर्सनल मैनेजमेंट. एज इन द प्रीवियस स्लाइड दैट वी नो दैट वी स्टार्टेड द प्लेलिस्ट फॉर द सब्जेक्ट ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट एंड ऑल्सो डिस्कस वेरियस टॉपिक्स रिलेटेड टू इट लाइक मीनिंग ऑफ ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट, मीनिंग ऑफ पर्सनल मैनेजमेंट, डिफरेंस बिटवीन पर्सनल मैनेजमेंट एंड ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट, evolution of personal management and human resource management and concept of human resource management and other videos also. You can also watch these videos, links are provided in the description box. So before I started the video, I want to say you that if you like my video, please like and share this video and don't forget to subscribe my channel, which is Learning with Dr. Shivangi. Now coming to the main topic, which is functions of personal management. So there are so many functions of personal management department as in the human resource management. So what are the functions we'll discuss here? All managers have direct responsibility for the human assets people in an organization and are responsible for activities and decisions concerning personnel. In this sense, all managers are personal managers. There are three categories of functions which the personal manager is expected to perform. So we'll discuss these functions in the upcoming slides. So basically there are so many functions of personal department or personal management in which we treat the employees of a organization as in human assets. So what are the functions? There are three types of functions. First is managerial function, second is operative function, and the last is advisory functions. So we'll discuss each of the point one by one in detail. So first one is managerial function. Personal manager is a member of management department, so he has to perform the basic managerial functions of planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling in relation to his department. So personal manager has to perform different types of functions in the department like these functions. The second function is operative function. So what is operative function? These functions are those tasks or duties which are entrusted to the personal department under general supervision of personal manager. So these functions are performed under the supervision of personal manager in the organization. There are various types of operative functions performed in the personal management, which are: first one is employment, second is training and development, third is working conditions, fourth is industrial relations, fifth is remuneration, sixth is motivation, and the last is personal records. So these are various types of operative functions performed by personal manager. Now we will discuss each of the functions one by one in detail. So first one is the employment. It is the first operative functions, function of the personal department, and it is the employment of proper kind and number of persons necessary to achieve the objectives of the organization. This function involves recruitment, selection, placement, induction, etc. of the personnel working in the organization. So basically in the employment function, the organization has to maintain different types of employees in the organization according to the objective of the organization. The second operative function is training and development. It is duty of management to train each employee properly to develop technical skill for the job for which he has been employed, and also to develop him for the higher jobs in the organization. So basically in the training and development, employees are provided different types of training according to the requirement of the job in the organization, and development of their skills also to get the better or higher jobs in the organization. The third operative function is the working conditions. These includes the measures of taken for health, safety and comfort of the workforce. The personal department also provides welfare services, that is counseling, group insurance, recreational facilities, etc. So basically employees are provided different type of working facilities in the organization related to welfare services also. The next operative function is industrial relation. Personal manager help in collective bargaining, joint consultation and settlement of disputes if they arise. So it is important for personal manager to maintain the peace or amicable relationship among the employees through different types of methods. The next operative function is remuneration. This function is concerned with the determination of adequate and equitable remuneration of the employees in the organization for their contribution to the organization goals. The personnel can be compensated both in terms of monetary as well as non-monetary rewards. So there are different types of methods to give the benefit to the employees in terms of monetary or non-monetary rewards. The next operative function is motivation. The personnel manager helps the various departmental managers to design a system of financial and non-financial rewards to motivate the employees so that employees get motivated time to time to perform their duties. The next operative function is personal records. Personal department maintains the records like training records, achievement records, transfer records, promotion records of the employees working in the enterprise. So this is the duty of the personal department also. The next function of the personal management is advisory function. Personal manager has specialized education and training in the managing human relations. He is an expert in his area and so can give advice on matters relating to human resources of the organization. He offers his advice to different types of management levels like top management, departmental head also. So, personal manager advises the top management in formulation and evaluation of personal programs, policies and procedures. He also gives advice for achieving and maintaining good human relations and high employee morale. So, personal manager also gives advices to top management in different types of policies framing in the organization. He also gives advices to the departmental head in the matters of such as manpower planning, job analysis and design, recruitment and selection, training and development, performance appraisal and so on. So, these are the various functions related to personal management department. I again summarize all the points so that you can easily understand about the topic. There are various types of functions of personal management department. First is managerial function, second is operative functions, third is advisory functions. Managerial functions are those functions like planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling in the department. Whereas operative functions includes various types of functions like employment, training and development, working conditions, industrial relations, remuneration, motivation and personal records. Whereas in the advisory functions, personal manager has to provide the advice to the departmental head as well as the top management of the organization in the policy making and the recruitment of the employees also. So this is all about the functions of personal management. If you have any query about this topic or if you want to know about any other topic related to business management, human resource management, research methodology, you can ask me through comment box. If you like my video, please like and share this video and don't forget to subscribe my channel, which is Learning with Dr. Shivangi. We'll meet in the next video with new topic. Thank you everyone.